All right, Kim, we're on. We're live.
We're live. Yay.
Yeah,
we made it.
We got people on. This is nice. I guess you're wondering what we're doing tonight. It's shock month, shock week. I saw a thing on the TV because I'm horrified of going to the ocean. I'll just say it right now. It don't matter, you know. And again, it brought me back to memories into Jaws.
Yep.
And we got to talk about that tonight because that horrified me when I was a kid. You know, but it's going to be fun. We'll talk about it, but I'm going to go. Let's do the opening. We'll come back. All right, so Kim, you got to say hi to everybody.
Oh, I got to say hi.
Yeah.
Hi.
So, I watching the news the other day, and they're talking about the sharks down the Cape. Now, you know, I lived on the Vineyard.
Yeah.
From 84 to 90, won't go in the water for the life of me.
I don't blame you.
No. Now, I got to, you know, Jaws came out in 1975, so 14 years old, and when it comes out. You know, we used to go up to Heights Beach. You remember the poles were out there, Kim?
Yeah.
With the signs, don't go past the whatever.
There's a lot of changes, even in the water from the 70s.
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't been up there in years, over 20 years, and I haven't been up there. So now, we used to swim out there all the time. We're up the beach. Now, I'm like 11, 12 years old, probably with a cigarette hanging out of my mouth. And everybody's up there. So I remember Larry Lanzillo is about 10 feet away from me. We're not even knee high in water. He wasn't, so and I'm a little kid, so I probably was at the time. He pulls a 3-foot shark out of the water, pulls it up on the beach. We're all going over there, stabbing it with sticks and whatever. It was fun, you know. I had no fear. I went to see Jaws, and that was the end of me with the ocean. I couldn't handle it anymore. Now there's all these attacks happening. I think there's like, in the United States, 54 a year, yeah. Something like that they came up with. But I got some news clips. I want to show them.
Go ahead.
I want to show everybody why I'm so scared. I think it's funny.
I want to see which one's the scariest.
All right, but this is about poor kid died a few years ago. Medici kid, yeah, God rest.
On the Cape are a great place in the summer. They attract a lot of people, and in recent years, that goes for sharks too.
The sharks, they'll go all over the place.
So far, no shark sightings off the coast of Massachusetts, but it's only Memorial Day weekend, and the season is still young.
June, July, we'll start to see some detections from white sharks. It'll continue to grow July into August with more detections into September and October, with October being the peak month of white shark activity.
Do you know if this is a male or a female?
The Atlantic White Shark Conservancy and the state have tagged more than 250 great whites as part of their research. Acoustic receivers have been deployed in the water to listen for those tagged sharks.
I would definitely recommend that people download the Sharktivity app.
This summer, the New England Aquarium is working with the Conservancy to analyze video gathered with the Sharktivity app. It allows people to send video of shark sightings to the experts.
A lot of the sightings that come in are actually not white sharks. People see everything from basking sharks to ocean sunfish.
There are a number of things being done to keep beachgoers safe on the Cape. They're urged to read the familiar signs and not wade into outer waters over their waists.
White sharks, when they're in this region, are spending almost 50% of their time in waters of less than 15 feet. So that's a big piece of information that, you know, we now know through some of that data.
The Sharktivity app is a great beach companion, helping everyone to get a better understanding of the great whites in the waters off Cape Cod. Inborn, John Maroney, NBC 10 Boston.
A popular stretch of beaches in Massachusetts will remain closed to swimming today because of a deadly weekend shark attack. 26-year-old Arthur Medici died Saturday after being bitten by a shark. It was the first deadly shark attack in Massachusetts in more than 80 years. The attack happened on a stretch of the Cape Cod National Seashore. Visitors are being told to stay out of the water. Nikki Batiste is in Wellfleet, Massachusetts, near the scene of the attack. Nikki, good morning.
Good morning. On Saturday around noon, Arthur Medici and his friend were riding waves on their boogie boards about 30 yards out into this water right off this Cape Cod shore. That's when one witness says he saw what looked like a 10 to 12 foot shark attack Medici.
The woman was just going like this, waving to us. And I ran up.
More than a dozen beachgoers on Cape Cod Saturday scrambled to help carry Arthur Medici to safety after he was bitten on both legs by a shark.
So I sprinted back up the beach, screaming like a lunatic, call 911, there's been a shark attack.
I have a report of an unknown shark bite.
Medici was rushed to a nearby hospital where he was later pronounced dead. Isaac Rochal was in the water near Medici when the attack happened. He says he and the victim were like brothers.
He was screaming, and then I saw like a shark tail, and I swam to him fast as I could in that moment. I dragged him back to shore, and I got a boogie board strap, and I tied it around his thigh to try to stop the bleeding.
Saturday's shark attack is at least the second on Cape Cod this summer. In August, 61-year-old Bill Litton survived after being bitten by a shark.
After two attacks, I think we can be concerned that it's a dangerous situation.
We see these sharks every day along this coastline. They are there in big numbers, and people have to be vigilant and be aware of it.
Greg Skomal is a marine biologist for the state of Massachusetts. He believes the shark likely mistook Medici for a seal, which are often close to shore along Cape Cod's beaches.
And as a result, these sharks are coming as close as they possibly can without risking their own lives to try to kill and eat these seals. And that creates a bit of a problem because that's exactly where people are utilizing the shoreline. And so, you know, this is something we're looking at. It's something we're trying to advise swimmers about so that this does not happen again.
The National Park Service is warning people on Cape Cod to not swim with the seals. And we've seen a few seals just a few yards offshore here this morning. And while shark attacks are rare, last year one study says there were 53 unprovoked shark attacks in the U.S. That's more than any other country in the world. John?
Nikki, thanks.
Unmute. All right, I am muted. No, John, you're right. It's an older clip, but that was the best clip that I could find. I thought it was pretty good, and I couldn't find the clip from a few days ago when I saw it, when they said the shark sightings were getting more. But you live down the Cape, John, so you should know more about that than I do. But I got to tell you, when I was a kid, my godfather brought me to see The Exorcist, and that scared the shit out of everybody. Yeah. Nowadays, people look at it, they laugh. They, you know, don't believe in a lot of that stuff, but that was a horrifying movie.
I worked with that demon.
Did you really?
Linda Blair's double.
Yeah.
Is as the demon. I worked with her on Clown Motel 2.
Did you really?
Yep.
Now look at how bad luck Linda Blair had after that movie. Mm-hmm. She was stereotyped on that. And that didn't scare me that bad. It really didn't. What could I have been then?
Right.
That's 73, so I'm 12 years old.
Yeah.
It scared me, but it wasn't that bad. What scared the shit out of me was Jaws. That was worse than a horror movie.
I remember it had to have been around the time Jaws came out. I was living down off of Shirley Ave, but yep. I was like right on, I can't even think of the name of the street, that it's like two streets away from where the amusement park used to be. Mm-hmm. Do you remember the amusement park? There was still rides left. In the 70s?
Yes. Oh, yeah. We still go up there. We used to take the train up there.
Right.
Yeah.
You used to be able to go to the rides on Revere Beach.
Yeah.
They had cleared the beach, and I remember hearing them saying, everybody out of the water, shock, shock, and it was like echoing through. So I heard it from where I was playing in front of my house.
Well, listen, I took some clips from Jaws. I hope everybody wants to see this, and then they don't think I'm crazy, but I had to show this tonight.
Go ahead.
Let me put this up. These are my favorite scenes. Now, they can hear me talking, Kim. They can hear us talking. This girl right here got hate mail for years. This is the part that horrified people.
Yes.
This was the worst of it right here.
I've worked with her at Comic-Con a few times.
There you go. She got hate mail from, you know, how many years, I don't know.
She's still good looking even after all these years.
Yeah, is she really?
She's still a beautiful woman.
I mean, this scene is just amazing.
Yep.
They had to open with this scene. Now, this is the story I found out. He didn't know a woman was going to kill the David. He was tied up with people. They shocked her. She was really in a panic. Why they were shooting the food. Yeah, watch now, watch. I got some more scenes. I had like a 12 and 40 minutes of stuff. I cut it right down to a few minutes.
Which you have to do. Because...
yeah. Because I know that they, hi, Tommy. Bobby, great background. Great to see you with Kim. This is my Wednesday night. Thank you both. God Almighty, I love the ocean, but I'm a pool guy. Me too. Ever since this movie, John, I'm a pool guy. I'm not a big deal in this day. For a lot of action. I'll tell you another component. It's only because you never really see the doctor's dog, which makes it scary.
Correct.
Slow ahead.
This is the scene. Sheila loves this scene.
We're going to need a bigger boat?
Yeah. Well, you know, Sam, there's two big lines on the engine
road. Slow ahead. Come on down and chum some of this shit.
We're going to need a bigger boat. This is an amazing, amazing. Look, Mark, into this. Look. Great movie.
Show me the tank.
I had to put this in. It's that him and Richard Dreyfuss. Fuck, the whole movie.
Fire, you son of a bitch! There we go.
Look at the monster in that. Richard Morello, 1975, Richard. We're going to go through all, we got a ton of stuff until after this. We're going to write the questions and answer.
All right,
got a problem. You know, all right, here, Kim. Yeah, it's going to go back to you. You got to undo the moving. Just remove it.
Yep.
And then we go back to everybody. Nice.
Sorry, guys, my mouse was upside down.
Not that one. Remove that. Yep.
Remove.
Yeah, there we go. Yeah. All right, we're back. Let's start going through these questions and answers over here.
All right. Am I scrolling all the way back up?
All the way back.
All right.
I don't want to miss nobody. There's a lot of great things that are going on.
Wait, can I do something?
Yeah.
I promise I'm not going to read tonight. Thank you, guys.
I like that.
I just had to. Sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, John put this up. Let me see. Bob, you should have caught. Yeah, because he lives down on the Cape. I know, John. That was a good idea. That would have been a real good idea for this.
That
one.
Was us.
Yeah. All right, Richard. Good evening, Bobby. Hope you're doing well. We are, brother. We're doing good over here, my friend. Alexis, hi, Bobby. God bless. Oh, Michael Hill. Good evening, Bobby and crew. Hi, Mike.
One second. There's a few of them.
Oh, there's a lot of them talking amongst themselves. Yeah. I suggest everyone here listen to Bobby teaching on faith. It's very good. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Big G.
Big G, my man.
All right, wait. Thank you, Big G. How you doing, sweetie? All right. Now, hi, Bobby.
Hi, Scott. All right. Mitt, Big Bobby, what's up, brother?
Hi, Scott.
Hi, Kim. Oh, hi, Keith. Good evening, Bobby. Fresh back from my camping trip. And time for your show. God bless, my friend. God bless you, Bo. Barry. Barry from New York. Hi, all. Bobby Luisi. What's up, Barry? How you doing, brother? We got to play you at that commercial.
Oh, okay. We're ready for a commercial already?
No, when it's time. Oh, my brother Richard's up there. Hi, Jeff. Hi, Bobby. When were you in Philly? Did you ever meet Jerry Blavitt? No, I never met him. I was mid to late 90s. I was at Philly. I think after 96. Hi, Richard. God bless you, brother. Hi, Bobby and everyone here in LA, California. What's up, Steve? Ozzy, bless you, brother. Thank you. All right, Ozzy. The Sharks are hungry. No thanks. You got to punch them in the nose if they come near. Yeah, well, the one in Jaws was 25 feet, 3 tons. I don't know. I could have heard him with that.
Not with
a
simple.
Don, greetings, brother. Lana, hi, honey. Hi, Bobby. Stay out of the water. I'd rather go to North End pool. Take my chances in there, honey. Yeah, John said this footage is for. Yeah, it was an old piece, but it was a good piece, John. That's why I put it up. I couldn't find a newer one. Because I heard somehow a woman got bit down the Cape, too. I don't know what happened with that. I couldn't find it. Big Vic, hi, Bobby. Hope you're doing well. Love the show. God bless, brother. God bless you. Thank you for tuning in. Oh, it is my brother right here, Mark. I always swam in the ocean. A couple of days ago, it was in the water in Boca. Let's stop there for a second. I got to tell a story.
Okay.
You know, I lived on Martha's Vineyard for 6 years. I wouldn't go in.
Yeah.
All right. And I used to go up to Wells. I mean, I'm sorry, not Wells, the Off Beach up in Maine. So finally, I want to go in the water, right?
Yeah.
So it was getting late, and I think I took the kids down. We were staying in the hotel across the streets. I think I took the kids down. You know, I just like got my feet in the water. It was freezing. You know that water's cold up there.
Oh, yeah.
I thought people popping up in the back. It was two seals staring at us. I said, come on, that's it.
Yeah, but I don't think I'm out of here.
You know, listen, when the stripers and the mackerels are running, the seals are behind them. And what's behind the seals?
Mm-hmm.
The sharks. You just won't do it. I won't go in. I won't go in the water.
Those scenes.
And you know what the worst part? I lived on the vineyard where they shot that in Vineyard Haven, Oak Bluffs, Eggertown. Thank you, Dale. Oh, Dale's getting the night off. Started right. Thank you, Dale. We'll never get mad at Super Chats, brother.
Nope. Sorry, yeah. I was just throwing that up as we were talking.
Oh, Michael, hello. That was a good one. Was just reading about crocodile attacks. Two pretty wild sharks and crocs. Listen, I've been watching the thing in Florida. They're going to pools.
Yep.
Imagine going in your pool. Oh. And there's a 12-foot. Yeah, no. I can't.
And what they say, serpentine, run side to side. They won't be able to catch you.
Yeah, okay. I can't even splash right, doggy paddle. Scott H., don't swim with the seals. You don't have to tell me. Well, I'm going to tell you something about the seals, Bo. Like I said, I saw the two up there. Scared the shit out of me. Because I heard they bite and they'll attack you too.
Yeah.
And then you don't know if there's a great white stalking them. Mm-hmm. No, I'm going to go in the water and splash them up.
Nope.
And what scared me afterwards, after I saw Jaws, Larry pulled the, well, that was before I saw Jaws pull the shark up. that we've been swimming up the ice beach with sharks all the whole time.
Remember, that's that we're in their house.
Yeah.
That's the other thing. That's why I don't like it. We're in their house. I don't want to be part of that.
Hi, Sean. Good evening, brother. All right, Mark, I'd rather go in the ocean than any other water here in Florida. Even when I got on a boat, Mark, and I was doing that a lot in the vineyard, I was nervous. All right, Scott, jaws scare lots of people out of the water. Yeah, yeah.
All right, I have a friend that, again, going back to my Clown Motel 2 movie that should be coming out. It should be going on to video or whatever streaming services, I believe the 30th. I'm not sure if it's the 30th of this month or next month. I'll get back to you on that. But August 28th, the lead role, Kelly Ritter, was actually in a movie that's coming out August 28th called Maneater. And it's about a giant shark. The trailer just came out today. And please look it up. Maneater with Trace Atkins and Kelly Ritter. Because it's scary. You thought Jaws was scary? This is a new scary. And she is awesome. She's in the trailer a few times. So check it out, guys.
I'm gonna look it up later.
You know? I think I posted it. I'll try to post it again for my site.
See, why I'm fascinated with this, because after Jaws, Shark Week every year, even in prison, we had the theater, I would watch it.
Oh, yeah.
I'd watch Shark Week. I loved it.
I won't watch it because it scares me.
Yeah, no, but I love how they get the seals. You know, it's sad when they go after people, but you know, it's really something.
Yep, a lot of gators in Florida.
Yeah. Hi, Greg. Oh, Daniel Luisi. That's another cousin.
That's another cousin. Hi, cuz.
Wherever the Luisis are, from here to New York. Hi, cuz. John O'Mast. I love the ocean, but I'm a pool guy. Me too, John.
Me too. That pool every time.
Yeah, yeah. All right, Tommy. Great background. Great to see you with Kim. This is my Wednesday night. Thank you, brother.
Thank you, sweetie.
Yeah, Mark. Jaws was a great movie. Great movie. Antonio. You never really see the shark. Oh, we read this.
Yep.
Yep.
Well, we were reading them.
No. We'll read them again. Oh, are you trying to ruin everyone's summer vacation? I knew someone was going to say that. I was thinking that myself. Should we really do this?
But, I mean, it's better to know than not know.
All right, Frank. Hello, Bobby. Who got inducted along with you? Was Anthony Nicodino one of them? No, Anthony, he must have got made after I went away. He didn't get made in my ceremony. And, you know, the guys on the street that I got made with, I don't want to say, you know, that's not right to do, but... It was me and another guy down there. Real good guy. Nice guy. All right, Phil. I'm 53 years old and The Exorcist still scares me. Godspeed. Jaws is also scary. You know, what the problem with me now with The Exorcist is because all my spiritual experiences and everything I went through, it's a little over the top, but that was based on a true movie.
Right.
Okay? And I might critique that movie. But that was based on a true movie, but it was about a little boy. It wasn't a girl. And, you know, they put that Hollywood in there with the spinning head and the spin up the pea soup. But I'll tell you, when that came out, that was amazing. That was an amazing movie.
That was.
Yeah.
Thank you, that one.
Drugs
was the best.
Yeah, 1975. Westport Beach is closed today because of shark sightings. See? Daniel, see? All right.
All right, we said this one, we answered that one, 1975.
Yeah. Now, you said all the Luisis came off in Ellis Island?
That's right. Our Luisis, the Luiso brothers.
Yeah.
Came in through Ellis Island, and that's where some of us got the O because of the way the signature was.
Right, but I'm saying that a lot of Luisis stood in New York, too, because when I was in MCC New York, you know, we used to get the paper every day. Yeah. There were Luisis getting married. Oh. No, I was seeing the name all the time.
Well, we know in Boston they're all related.
Oh, yeah.
Some of us don't know it.
I know. Hi, Jason. Good evening, brother. Let's see what we got here. if we were to shoot today, PETA would protest cruelty to sharks. Yeah.
You're right. They've done that already.
I know. I think we're going to need a bigger boat, Steve. And I know, listen, leave the gun, take the cannolis. Those are probably the two biggest lines from Hollywood. Big G, yeah, Bobby, fun fact, the kid that played in the movie actually became chief of police, one of the Cape Cod. All right, remember when I showed the scene just now and the kid was getting eaten on the raft?
Yeah.
That was Michael.
Yep.
He was in that scene. He was all the way on the right-hand side with the, all the little boys were playing
right
when the kid was getting eaten.
Yes, and the mother was looking for him.
Right, he did. He became the chief of police. That I saw her on the news.
Yep.
You know, and when I see Jaws, do you remember when Michael was in the pond? That's State Beach.
Oh,
my kids used to play over there, and he was on the boat. The father made him go on the pond, and then you see the shark going under the bridge.
Yeah.
We used to go fishing over there.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's where we used to go fishing. And where the girl got eaten, the first scene, that's Salt Beach.
Oh, I didn't know that.
In Eggertown, that we used to see. Oh. I think Beth used to take the kids to State Beach because it was calm there, the water.
Right.
You know, with the shark went under the bridge. Mm-hmm. You know, but after work, me, Mumbo, Mark, these guys know Mumbo, and my crew, my carpentry crew, we used to go to South Beach. They used to get the cooler with the beers, and we used to go sit down there.
My house times have
changed. Oh, I know.
Things but we can't do anymore.
You know, the Vineyard is amazing. And that's why they changed the town to Amityville. They were not, they didn't want to ruin the island.
Yeah.
Snuck in the theater near Mass General, swimming down the point right after. Yep. We are all listening now, Bobby. You got our attention. All right, Anne-Marie. Hello, Bobby. Hope you're doing good. Hi, honey. Oh, they're saying hi to you, Kim.
Hi.
Dale White, always an honor, Kim and Bobby.
Thank you.
Tell Joey hi. We will. All right, we got a good question here. Okay. Where is the Patriarchus family strength today? Providence or Boston? What is Louis Menachio up to these days? Okay. Right now, that's probably a toss-up because the family isn't that big anymore. There might be a bigger crew down in Rhode Island. I'm not sure. Louis Menachio was retired in Florida, as far as I know. But, you know, the mafia up here isn't what it used to be. Now, Emily came. I shot the show when I'm editing it right now. And we're breaking down the whole Boston mob. We started from 1895. They're going to see in the show, there was an article that came out at that time that said that they believed there were 200 made men in Boston then. Because all the Sicilians were coming over.
Yeah.
And the first boss in Boston was Joe Messina. Not to be confused with the guy in New York.
Right.
But this is going to be a great series. What we did on this first one is just give a rough summary of where we're going to go. We talked about a lot of people. Right. But now she's going to slow it down. You know, there was King Solomon here, all the Irish crews.
Well, I think that's what some of the historians or like some of our fans, they know the history. But when you're working, it's like you any job, you can work with, you know, 100 people. Yeah. You don't know every single one of them. You're not actually connected to all of them. But, you know, so like you being in the situation, you're taking care of your situation. You don't always know, you know, the five guys that got made 3 weeks ago.
Right, exactly.
Because you're, you know.
Yeah, exactly.
And that's
what
these historians are helping clarify for some of us.
Well, this is what we're doing with this series. I don't know how many parts it's going to be, but we're starting back there, go to Prohibition. We went over a lot of subjects fast on the first show just to show everybody what's going to happen. But I think that's going to be a long series because we're going to go, again, from 1895. All the way up to today.
But like you said before, you're learning a lot.
Oh yeah.
Because you were in it. You didn't see some of the stuff that was going on because you were focused on.
Listen, you know how it is in Cosa Nostra. A lot of guys, they want to know everything.
Yeah.
I wasn't one of them guys. I really didn't care. I knew the guys that I saw when I grew up in the 60s and the 70s right. and the 80s, and then we came in the 90s. So it's like, that's what I was concerned about. I didn't care about anything else. What was around me, that's what I was. So really, I was never a mafia historian.
Right.
I didn't care what was going on in New York or Philadelphia or anywhere else, Detroit. I could care less. We're up here, we're in Boston. This is my life, you know?
Yeah.
But now it's like, what good stuff she has.
Yeah.
It's amazing. It's amazing.
That's what it comes down to. Like, as I've seen some comments come through, like, you don't know everything. No, you can't know everything.
No, I don't. I'll be the first one to admit that.
You know, and that's the hard part.
Yeah.
All right, let's go here.
Bobby, you need to get Frank D'Amato as a guest on your show. He has some excellent stories. Frank's done the show. But I'm going to call him and see him do Wednesday Night Live again.
Yeah.
Frank's a great guy. I did Comedy Central with Frank.
Yes, you did.
Yeah.
Jason.
Yeah, he's a good guy. Hi, Jason.
Hi, Jason. How you doing, sweetie? All right. Thank you, Anne Marie.
Hi, Michael. What's up, Bobby? The dog can't stay Don Vito ill, even lower the rent. Ha, ha, ha. That was a good scene.
That was a good scene.
It really was a good scene.
And I'm glad the dog got to stay.
That, I'll tell you, that guy that played the landlord, the way he was stuck, wow. I'll tell you, he did unbelievable. All right. Jellyfish sucked too, especially the Portuguese man of war. Yeah. Yeah, you better be careful. Well, they say if you get stung by that, you're supposed to pee on them.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's a true thing.
I don't know if that's a true thing either.
I don't know.
I'm not Googling that.
Hello, Bobby and Kim. What's up, Mr. C? The other guy from Boston. Oh, everybody, do you see my new picture that my friend sent me? This is Joe Russo.
Ah.
I think that's Action Jackson, whoever that is. I forget who that is in the picture. But look at Joe Russo's picture. Is that awesome or what?
Not a bad looking guy.
Yeah. Well, he was the man, so, you know, I got to put that up on the wall. All right, Big Tuna, did you go to Vegas and do the Mall Museum event? No, I didn't. When I went to Vegas, I did the show with Larry Mazda. We were supposed to go inside the museum and do a show in there, but that never happened. They couldn't schedule that right. But I do talk to them down there, and they said as soon as my book comes out, they want me down there. So I got to call them when Capital Christian actually comes out in print, you know. Right. August 1st, then I'll call him and tell him I got a book. I'll send it to him. All right. Jay Diesel, I'd rather freeze in Maine Ocean than swim on the Cape. Well, I'll tell you, the kids, everybody used to go. We go up to York or Wells mm-hmm. and stuff. They used to go in the water. Me, I just, All right. Bobby, my father ruined me with that movie too. Thanks to Josh, I have not swum in the ocean since 1975. See, he's another one.
Yeah, a lot of people.
Yeah. This was a good subject tonight, not for mm-hmm. nothing. All right, Bobby, when Paul Castellano was hit in New York, did it affect business in Boston at all? He had connections in dealing with so many people. It really didn't. That I remember, it had no, you know, that's another family. It happened up there. No, not that I know of. I never heard the other older guys talk about it, that it affected them in any way, you know. But the whack itself affected every family. You never said it. You never hit a sitting boss. That was insane what they did. But it was them or him.
Yeah.
You know. All right, Frank, if you enjoy Molino Cross Pass today by chance, how do you think it will go? I don't know, but he get all the love from me, so. I still respect him.
That was a triple one.
Oh, was it? Yeah, I still respect Joey, so God bless him, you know. All right, the clean is here. Hi, gang. Hi, Uncle Bobby. Hi, Kim.
Hey, sweetie.
All right, we did that one. Oh, wait a minute, hold on. If Joey were to pass on or get life, Who do you think would be the official boss position for Philly? I think it would be Lancelotti. He's doing a great job now. I don't see why it would change. He's a good man, you know. It's either him or Steven. What do you think about Joe Bonanno writing that book that outlined La Cosa Nostra, and that's how Giuliani put the commission away? I'll tell you, that was a shame, you know, coming out like that and doing what he was doing. You can't legitimize Cosa Nostra. And that Italian movement wasn't a good idea. Well, that's why they try to whack him, yeah. You know. The Godfather books, Tom Hagen drowned in a swamp. It's hinting that alligators ate him. I didn't know that was in the book. I never read the book.
I didn't read the book.
No, I didn't know that.
Why read the book? They were going to make it into a movie anyway.
Yeah, Chris, Sonny Francese is a lay. Of course he is. Yeah, that was a gangster. That was a man's man. Have you ever attempted to get Sammy's show or vice versa? I've talked with Sammy. Hopefully we'll do either show soon. I'm hoping. I got to call him again. Last time I talked to Sammy, someone in his crew had COVID. Then I heard he came down with COVID. Then he was doing some things on TV. I just haven't bothered him, you know. Plus, you remember things happened here.
Yeah.
The last few months. Yeah. So, but I'm getting ready now to call him. Everything's back in place. Thank God, because of a lot of good people. Jeff Kearney. If you did get attacked by a shark, try to flip upside down. It puts them in a catatonic state. And they, listen, let me tell you that. Coogee, listen. I got a 20-footer coming at me. I don't think I'm going to be able to flip him. I don't know what I'd be. I try to poke him in the eye maybe while he's eating me. I don't know what I would do. But I don't know about flipping him. But there are a lot of things like that.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I've got faith that Kim is going to master the comments tonight.
Thank you, Andrew. Yeah. Part of the reason it is I'm not reading them tonight. So when you just want to have a little fun, the most fun you've had with clothes on in a while, I'll do the reading.
Yep.
You didn't catch that one.
No, I didn't. I was reading Ozzy's comment over here. Question. There isn't many priests around anymore that perform exorcism. Stay close to God and keep your family in the spirit of Christ. After seeing that movie, I couldn't sleep for a month. Well, I'm going to tell you, there are a lot of people that do exorcisms. They're really outside of the church. Well, they're probably a lot of non-denominational, Pentecost, different movements. It's not all on the Catholic Church anymore. And I'm going to tell you something about exorcism. Whoever performs it, whatever religion they walk out from, they got to be ready.
Yeah.
They got to fast. They got to get spiritual, right? Because let me tell you, those demons that are inside these people know all about you when you're coming.
Yep.
They know all about you. So if you're not in right shape, it's like going on a football field without practicing. Just putting the uniform and going, you're going to get killed.
Yeah.
You're going to get killed. You know?
They're not going to make it easy.
No. So you got to be ready. You got to be ready for that.
All right. Since we're a little past time, you want to go to a commercial?
Yeah, let's do that. Let's put up the beer commercial.
You want to do the beer commercial? Is there music to it this time?
No, I forgot. I got it up there. I forgot to bring it down because I brought down the other stuff.
All right.
Let's do it, though. Put it on.
We'll put it on.
And I'll talk right through it. Thank God in my life I don't need something like this. You know, but I guess it helps a lot of people. It gives them that boost, you know?
Yeah.
So, you know, we're playing this for Barry, my friend.
Hi, and Barry.
Like I said, go up, guys. Check it out. You know,
we're
secure. It's private.
Commentary from people that have tried it.
I don't think anybody's ever going to step up and say anything, Kim. I got to be honest with you.
Well, they might say it tastes good.
But I put music to this. Next week, there's going to be music on that commercial. Oh, that's too funny. All right. American made. How about these sharks that travel up these rivers for miles? And look, that's another thing. You know how many shows I saw on that? Kids swimming in a, you never expect it. And they're coming right up. I think a lot of the bull sharks do that, huh?
They don't do that in a pool.
No, 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 only alligators. Only alligators.
Only alligators.
They like the pool.
They like the pool.
Yeah, they go up rivers now.
Yeah.
All right. Jaws would be a good restaurant name. It would. Seafood Delight. I like that. Phil, is that the Amityville same place as the Haunted House? No, no, no. They filmed that on Martha's Vineyard. Like I said, they called it. And, you know, Martha's Vineyard is in one town. There's seven towns on that island. But they call the whole island Amityville. They had to protect that, you know, for tourists. Big G, yeah, my cousin wanted to go to Cape Town, Africa. He wanted to do the cage shark. I think he's not. I would never do it.
Nope.
Listen, Australia, all the way down there, these sharks are 30 feet long down there. They're all man-eaters. There's beaches there. They have to actually have, they got gates up that they can't get in.
Yeah, nope. The,
not going to happen.
Know. You never know.
All right, Big G, the Godfather scene in the car, make sure you clean the mattresses. They exterminate them. That, yeah, I remember that. That was a good one. That was a good one. All right, Vinnie Jackson. All right, so I forgot. I know you said that. I forgot. But thank you again for that photo. It's great, isn't it?
Yeah.
I love that. I put it right up. I took Big Bob down, but I'll put him up there again. I got to make a new picture.
Point out Vinnie again?
Huh?
Which one's Vinnie?
This is Joe Russo, and this is Vinnie.
Thank you very much for that clarification.
Yeah. Douche Marouche, what happened to the guy with the cheese shop in the North End? And was he getting regular cholesterol checkups? You're talking about Carmen D'Annunzio. I don't know where Carmen is. I got no idea. The cheese man. Oh, Clyde, what's up, Bo? Bobby, did you wear shorts while in the life? Yeah, I did. Not much. I did not, like when I was hanging around in the North End, I wore jeans and scarpers, but I never really wore shorts that much in the neighborhood. Frank, you ever hear any secondhand information on who actually did the work on Jimmy Hoffa? Like I said before, when I was in prison, back 20 guys, you get 20 different stories, 20 different guys did it. I don't, you know, I really don't know. I really don't know.
Well, I know it's in my backyard. I need some work done. So maybe if they come dig it up for me,
I know, right?
Can till it over.
I know. They're looking to go to dumps in New York. They were in Detroit. They killed this guy. They're going to drive him across country in a barrel to bury him in Jersey or New York. This is all crazy nonsense. It really is. All right, Sean, it's sort of a miracle that Gotti became boss. You never hear of a soldier that's close to being shelved, whacking a boss and then becoming a boss. Yeah, it's unheard of. When you whack a boss, you're not supposed to become a boss. If you're in on that hit, you're not supposed to, you know. That was old Sicilian, not now, but.
That's when you could tell times changed.
You know, he had Frankie next to him. He had Sammy the Bull. He got the right couples together to do what he had to do. And what that showed the rest of the family is, well, if you got the power and the balls and the guys with you, then you could make that move. And this is why the Chin wanted to kill him all those years and hated him, you know? Salvatore, hey, what's up, Bobby? How is the day going? Sandy and I say hello and lots of love for you. Thank you, brother. And Kim, you are doing a great show tonight.
Thank you.
And it's so wonderful. Thank you, Salvatore. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
God bless you both. Frank. Did Joey ever express his opinion on Angelo Bruno or Salvi Tessa to you or around you? No, I never heard Joey saying anything about them. You know, his heart on was with Stanford, so, and that crew. Also, did Joey respect New York when he wasn't in their presence? Yeah, he always did. Those guys down there, believe me, no matter what stories you hear, whatever, they're causing Austria. And they respect it. But if they were disrespected by any family in New York, then Joey would speak up. And I know that firsthand. Hi, Sherry. Hello, everyone. Just stopped by to say hello to Barbie and everyone before I take my little boys to go see the Minions movie. Oh, she wants to see the Minions movie.
We're jealous.
Are you putting the suits on them? I seen a commercial. These kids were wearing suits. They'll go see that.
Well, some of them, I guess, were getting banned from even doing that. I don't know why.
Well, I heard they were messing up the theaters or something.
Oh, well, that's a possibility.
You know? I don't know. All right, Chef. Have a good night, huh? Sean Miller. Barbie, in the 90s, if a May guy saw an informant from another family, were you required to do something or alert people? Or did most guys just mind their own business? Well, I'm going to tell you a lot of things, and I'm going to tell you what some of these real good stand-up guys did. When they saw a rat, they would say, oh, he didn't rat on me. I got no beef with him. That's a true story. That's a true story.
And how many believe them?
Huh? Listen, it got so watered down, no one even cared. Nobody but a very close friend that I love, Frank Rossi, came to me and said, there was this kid, Mucka, and he was already in prison. Mucka. I ended up being in prison with Mucka. But there was another kid with the same nickname running around up in Somerville. And I was in the Somerville area with my crew. He says, Bobby, he comes to me. Now, Frankie did a lot of years, bad guy, right? Bobby, how you letting this guy run around? What guy? This guy, Mucka. Mucka. I said, the guy's a young kid, Frankie. No, he did this and that. I said, I think you got the wrong guy. So in other words, he came at me because he thought I was allowing this kid to run around. Meanwhile, the guy he was talking about was already in prison. There are stand-up guys, they're not gonna stand for that.
Right.
You know, they won't want me to stand for that. But you know, you hear stories about people in the street, oh, I think he's a rat. If a guy don't like you, he might pin anything on you. He might call you off a fag. You can't listen to everybody. You got to make sure, you know?
Like, what's that show, The Survivor or something?
Yeah.
You know, you got to be careful because they reach out for their own.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, Alexa, I just got Jaws on DVD. Love it. Yeah, it's a great movie. Great movie. You know what else? And I showed on that commercial because Sheila got it on her phone.
Mm-hmm.
She's got the shock alert.
Oh, really?
So she puts it on. You could see all the way down Mass, the Cape, where they are at the time.
Oh, yeah, no, that would freak me out.
Well, you know, she was up in Maine and all that, and you know, she liked that. But someone told her to put her on the phone. She could see it all. But that was on that news thing I played. They showed that shock thing. That's a good thing.
It's good if that interests you, if you go in the water or, you know,
that would That would freak me out.
That would freak me out, too.
All right, Michael, tell me, Bobby, where some of the money is buried. Sadly enough, it's all on the street, my friend.
I went looking, he got mad at me.
Yeah. All right, go get it, he's all right. Carmen Lupatazzi told Tony Soprano, a Don never wears shorts. Tony wore shorts. We could be comfortable too. You know, I was never a Don. But, you know, wise guys could be comfortable too.
Yep.
But I'm going to tell you, the old timers I grew up with, you'll never see them with shorts on. Not on Hanover Street. Right. Not in East Boston. But if you went to their barbecues and everything, yeah. When you got in with Philly, did you ever hear any of them mention anything about Pittsburgh? Not really. No. Not really. Not Pittsburgh. Hi, James. Hello, Bobby. I'm happy to be here tonight. Thank you so much for being here, brother. It means a lot. Frank, what was New York's position during the Stanford-Milito War? Which family supported who? Well, the New York guys, they say, sent Stanford down there to try to put all whatever's dysfunction down there back together. But Stanford made it more dysfunctional. And Stanford wanted to take all these zips in. And he was pissing everybody off. So you know, my side would have been with Joey. But you know what New York does, and they did it with us up here? They just see where it levels out. The only time that I know New York got involved with what was going on up here was over Raymond Jr., Petriaca, because of his father. They didn't want him getting hurt. Other than that, they really stayed away. All right, where are we going next? Arturo, how do you feel about the Italian Mafia President Springfield Mass now? Well, they've always been down there. And when you say the Italian Mafia, you talking Zips or are you talking the Genovese? Because the Genovese were down in Springfield, one of the deals that were made. You should try to get Mikey Scars on the show. I did time with Mikey Scars. Me and Mikey were in MCC together. I don't know. We might have been together for about a year. I like Mikey a lot. I don't know how to get in touch with him, but I should call him anyway and say hi to him. You know. Paulie P, hello, Bobby, and everyone. Hi. Do I think that Joey Messina will ever appear on YouTube? I don't know. He's writing books now, I think, right? Joe Messina, I don't know.
He might be.
Yeah. Clyde, Bobby, have you ever visited Buffalo or know anybody in the Buffalo mob, guys? No. No, I never had the time with any of them either. What is your opinion on Vincent the Chin Gigante? I'll tell you, I think at one point, Carlo Gambino was the most powerful guy in New York. But second to none, it was definitely the Chin. Everything I've heard about the Chin and the guys been around him, he was ruthless.
Yeah.
He was a boss's boss, and everybody feared him. Probably one of the most feared guys in New York that ever come out of there because took no garbage from nobody. Well, you see what he did to Frankie DiCicco. When they whacked Paulie, you know, he stood right up and, you know, he had that done because he's not going to take that nonsense. But as far as Cousin Ostra, he was the guy.
So now you knew who some of these were. So like you go into some place, is there some place you walked into that there was somebody you feared because you knew what they did or more if you knew you were going to get confronted by something, what feared you? You know what I mean? Like, what feared you in somebody?
I never had fear like that.
Okay.
I never, not that I can remember.
Good question. You know what I
mean? No, that was a good question. The only one that made me really nervous one time was Joe Russo because he was in a bad mood. And Junior tried to introduce us. This is Bobby Luisi's son. And he was real snippy and snappy. You know, I used to see him all the time, Maverick Square, whatever. And I just like backed up a few feet and I just stood there, didn't say two words. But I was in my 20s, you know, wasn't a pushover, but it was Joe Russo, you know. So that was the only time I ever felt a little intimidated by anybody, really.
Yeah, that's a good word.
Yeah, that was about it, though. Because I grew up with all the other guys.
Right.
It, you know. Who and Dr. Merlino? I think it was Stanford. Actually, to bring in the Young Turks. I think that's what he was doing. Youngstown mob. No, you know who knew a lot about Pittsburgh, Youngstown, all these crews was Bobby Garanti that passed away. And Bobby was, we were together for years and he ended up going away. Bobby passed away now. He's the one that was involved with the art museum. He knew all those because the Pittsburgh guys, we're going to send guys up here when we're in the war. But I would have had to put them up, pay them. I said, no, we ain't doing that. We're all right. Bobby, give me the list. I'm just kidding. Who's the painting of the boxes up? That's Rocky and...
Other side.
That's Rocky and come on.
Apollo Creed.
That's Rocky and Apollo Creed. That's supposed to be a famous painting.
Wait. I got a name name right.
Yeah, you did. You did.
I got my name right.
We're going to put a gold star on your forehead. You know, you're a teacher. We'll put the gold star.
I needed that.
Yeah. All right, Big G. Yeah, Bobby, I don't know why they don't make an invisible line in the water with the systems and tag the sharks with systems. Well, the sharks, like I said, that are tagged, they come up on that app on the phone, you know, but I think there's a lot more they could do. But then again, you know, it's a wild animal.
Yeah.
You know, it's hard. All right, the chimp broke the rules. He walked around in his boxes, a bathrobe, and a shower cap to protect his head. Listen, that was all an act. Everybody knew it. When he sat down at a sit down or a meeting, believe me, he didn't act like that. And they finally caught him. This man was very intelligent.
Yeah.
Very intelligent man. It was all an act. I guess he must have got away with it one. Because I heard a story when they went in the house, he was sitting in the shower with an umbrella. I mean, these are stories that you hear. I don't know.
But you know what I mean? Like somebody comes in and you go in to get somebody and they're sitting there in the shower with an umbrella. Like that's going to mess with your head.
Yeah. Yeah. So it was an all. I was with guys that were around him. It was just all an act.
Yeah.
They feared him. I'm telling you.
I like that one.
No one got away with nothing with him. Bobby, in the 70s, I didn't even think our dads wore sneakers. No, Richie, they didn't. No. My father, your father, they didn't wear sneakers. You know that big bot. No, Duffy, they didn't wear sneakers.
No, and they.
No, you couldn't because, listen, in the midst of the summer, Ralphie Chong, Johnny, Richie, Jerry, they were all dressed every day. Larry Bioni, 90% of the times I saw him, he had a suit on. That was a different era. Paulie and Tizo, Don and Jero's, that whole crew all had suits on every day. You couldn't do that then.
But that's how my uncle, I knew him and his uncle changed.
Yeah.
Because you could hear the change because of his slacks. You know what I mean? If they were jeans, you couldn't hear somebody coming down. If
no.
You have change in your slacks, you'd hear that.
But I think I was about, 16, 17, and the Sicily jeans came out, the Clipper jeans. Yeah. And then the style started changing. And then Nike, I remember the first pair of Nikes, but they were clogged and shitty, but we thought they were great because we used to wear the Converse.
Yep.
Like the ones in prison. You know, and then it's just the eras just started to change. The styles changed, the people changed.
Yeah.
We all became too Americanized.
That's what it is.
That's what it was. We all became too Americanized. Is Nikki Calabrese still a witness protection? I don't think so. I know he was getting out sometime after me because the last time I saw Nikki, I had the 20 years. I won the appeal. I went back to Phoenix. I was with Nikki for a little while before I went to Allenwood. And I think he got a pretty good deal himself, you know. All right, let's see where we are. Sean Miller. RJ is pretty close to Mikey Scars. I can ask him to reach out to him for an interview since you know each other. Yeah, please do that. Then please just go up to BobbyLuisi.com, Sean, and just send me the info. I'll give it to Mike. Chosen. Bobby, has Philadelphia ever said hello to you or reached out to you since you've changed your life? I believe they honor a brother. Well, I'm going to tell you, no, they haven't directly done that, but not a bad word came from them. And I'm going to tell you, a guy that's very close to me, did time with Joey, and you know he was in the same cell with him. And he says, "Listen, Bobby never hurt me or any of my guys. I got no beef with him." You know, when you're in that life the way they are, and you feel that anybody walks away from it, doesn't want any part of it. There's some resentment, but that goes away. That's over 20 years ago. I still love and respect them guys. They may not feel that way about me, but I still feel that way about them. You know. RJ's channel is Black Hand Print Mafia. Maybe I could do his show, push up my book. Bobby, you should interview Mike McGowan. I don't think Mike would do that, but that would be a good interview. I'd probably end up getting into it with him. You know? All right, what else? We'll do one more. Then we got to do a commercial.
Yeah.
My neighbor was passed, and a Sicilian told me years ago. That's it. I don't know. I think he spelt that wrong. Send that back again, Steve. All right, you know what I want you to play?
Which one do you want me to
the
play?
The one that, the 2-minute one that I did. See, it says book calm.
Yep.
That one there. Oh, hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me right now. I just want to talk about my new book coming out from Copper to Christian. You know, it's been years I've been wanting to put this book out. I wrote most of it in prison. And I'm proud of the book. And, you know, the content of the book, it just shows you, it goes from my childhood right through the war in the 90s. And, you know, what happened to me that night that everybody wants to know about, that demonic encounter that I had that lasted over 8 hours. That's all in that book. I don't get deep into the war. I don't get descriptive with anything. Emily is going to be doing a book of my life story. That's really going to be detailed. But this book here is, I wrote it as a testimony. So, I really believe that, you know, you'll enjoy the read. What I'm going to do is I'm selling it on Etsy and eBay right now on pre-sale. People already started to come up and pre-order the book. It's amazing. I had a feeling this was going to happen. What I want to do for the first several months or more is actually handle every book, personally sign them, and mail them out to the people. So, I don't know. I mean, I think by the time the book comes out, I don't know how many are going to be there, how many I'm going to need, how many are mailing out. But I'll tell you what I'm going to do. As the orders come in, that's the order that the book's going to go out. If you're second, third, fourth, fifth, 10th, 20th, that's how they're going to go. So if you like, go up to Etsy now, go up to eBay, pre-order your book. And as soon as they come rolling off the press, they're going to be mailed to you. All right. Thank you. And I hope you enjoy the read. All right. Let's go. Where are we? All right, Frank. Is there anyone in particular from the life that you would try to cause trouble for you today if they seen you in person? Probably not. I don't think it would be smart for them. I don't think they'd want to do that. Not that I'm a big tough guy, a killer or anything anymore, but I think it would be stupid for them to do that. There are people up here that try to get involved with some of the things that I'm doing behind my back, but, you know, things like that work out and get taken care of. So where are we now, Sean? The agent said he was naked with an umbrella and had a hat on. See? Yeah. That's a true story. He had a hat on, too. I didn't know he had the hat on. Yeah. What was Bobby Garanti's nickname? Unc. We used to call him because he was someone's uncle in the crew, and we used to call him Unc for sure. Have you ever heard anything about John LaRocca or Michael Genovese from Pittsburgh? No. No. Salvatore. I live 4 doors down from where Maker was killed at Ceremony's Restaurant. Ceremony's Restaurant. Wow. My neighbor was Sicilian, told me years ago her uncle was boss. If LA family, his name was Nicolo Lacata. He was boss late from late 60s till his death in 1974. He probably was. There was a big crew down there. Look at this. I'm burping again. Yeah. I think it's the tea or the coffee, does
it? It could be.
Maca, yes. Yep. And Maca ended up getting killed anyway, the kid on the street. What do the Philly guys have to say about Frank Sheeran, if anything? Nothing at all. All right, Mike. What's up, brother? I remember when they wore the box, there was a piece on LaGrange Street in the combat zone called Harry the Hatter. Yes, I remember that when I was a kid. Because, you know, I used to have to go up there to see Big Bob on LaGrange Street to pick up money every week. Imagine this. He had me in strip joints, 13 years old.
I'm surprised it wasn't my father-in-law.
Oh, he was across the street at the bookstore. Yeah, I know. Who did the work on Johnny Gongs from Philly? I have no idea. No idea. John. I drove by some gangbangers 20 minutes ago, and they all had slippers with socks on. It makes no sense to me to be so relaxed when you have enemies. That's right. It's ridiculous. We seen a bunch of them today. We went down to Malden Square. One of the kids had a mask on. Oh, what are they doing, these kids? Shorts on, flip-flops with the socks.
Yeah.
His hand down his pants. Come on. Do you know the old-time black guys that I was with, they couldn't stand them?
No.
These kids were doing?
Well, that's...
Because those old-time black guys are men. They were men. They were gangsters.
Yeah.
They didn't act like this. I'd hear them tell they could pull your pants up. I used to tell the kids that, pull your pants up.
Now they tell you pull your mask up.
Yeah. No, but I'm saying, saw what is in prison. They don't really, these kids are... Jolly Joe, did you ever talk to Joey or anyone of the Philly guys about Nicky Scafo? Curious how they spoke of him. All I ever heard Joey speak about Nicky Scafo was good things. He never heard anything bad. Tell me stories about when he was a jockey and around Nicky. Never heard nothing bad out of Joey's mouth about any of them or the other guys. Michael, Bobby, you got to do something like Mike Francese. I got 68 emails a day from him. You got to get into people's emails like that too. You know, we were talking about that, Michael, and, you know, we're starting to post, you know, Sherry sends prayers. We're starting to post that for the ministry. And we're going to start putting that together. You know what the problem was, Mike? Don't get me wrong. I got Kim here to help me. But the day-to-day, I do everything. And Kim will tell you.
Yeah.
I edit the shows. I put the things together. I call the people. It's really hard for me. You know, Michael, God bless, he's got a team. He got his kids.
Yeah.
They're all involved. His son-in-law does, the cameras for him.
I'm sure he's got a program that actually sends out the...
Michael was always very smart with business anyway. We all know that. He had a lot of legal businesses besides the gas and the gangster nonsense. You know, but the thing is, it's well put together.
Right.
And this is why I said that you produce a certain way, but we need a producer that's going to take care of all these things.
Right.
But now we do have help, and I have help.
And we're getting there slowly.
Yes.
We're getting there slowly.
Yeah.
And we have setbacks, but that's okay.
Yeah. And the help I have, she's very beautiful, so it's very distracting. So a lot of things I can't get done, but she'll do it. But, yeah, we're going to start putting this stuff together. Yeah. I'm from Allowood, Pennsylvania. What family controlled that area? I'm not sure, but I was in Allowood. I did the rest of my time there. Big G. Oh, here we go. Thank you, G. And, G, I got all the information together. Probably tomorrow, Friday, I'll have all that package together for the church. When the package is done, I'm going to send it to you to show you what we did. So you'll be proud. All right, brother?
Sorry, thank you. Scott, we'll get back to your question.
Okay, where are we going?
We're going back because you were talking a little bit about that.
No, I did time in Allenwood. See, because the Philly guys went up so far. I know the Pittsburgh guys, you know.
Yep.
I don't know how far they came down, because when I was around them, we went to Delaware and different areas. They had a lot of control. South Philly, South Jersey, you know, we were in different areas. Not me, that, you know, them.
Yeah.
But I really didn't get too deep into them or what they were actually doing. It wasn't my place to do that.
Right.
You know, so I don't know how far up actually out of Philly and Delaware they actually went, to be sure. Bobby is the boss of YouTube, one of the other channels that's not consistently putting down other people in channels. We're not here to do that, brother. I don't know why they're doing this to each other.
We like to say we thank our fans and viewers for noticing the respect that we do have.
Yeah.
So thank you, American Made. We appreciate
that. Hey, Sammy. JR's behind you. Yeah. With two, Vinny Jackson. I know it's blurry back there, but that's a guy I well respected too, Sammy Granito. I'll never forget, Haymarket, they used to have the Coliseum. So at the end, they were going to rip it down. They were going to build a hotel. So they gave it to my father to run to do. You know my father, always with the after-hour clubs and everything. So we're up there. Sammy comes up. We all got to be quiet because it was Sammy, you know. And he's looking around like, what are these guys doing? We're ripping the whole place apart. My father, everything was black paint and a crystal ball. You know, it was old and run down, but it was a beautiful bar. Ripped everything down, Big Bob. He had us up there for months. Make a long story short, I never forget when Sammy or Larry or any of these guys came in, what respect they got. Really, you know.
Time's gone by.
All right, Frank. How was Philly able to maintain a crew in North Jersey? Was that crew valuable to the family? I really don't know how valuable Peter Crum and his crew was up there, any work that they did. I'm really not sure. I never actually, you know, I kept telling Pete, you know, a few times I seen him at parties, I'm going to stop by and say hi to you guys, but I never did. They didn't seem too relevant down there in Philly, but they were an important crew because Pete was a capo like myself, and, you know, he had some control in that area. So it was good to have a guy that close to New York. But it ended up that Peter Crum was turning on our family and trying to hook up with the Genovese and the Gambino guys. But that's another story. That all came out. Robert Urich. Bobby, salute from Suffolk County, Long Island. Stay strong and positive. Thank you, brother. Thank you. Sean Miller. I've always assumed Philly made a lot of money. When I was there in 2015, all the mob-connected businesses only accepted cash. Yeah. Those guys made money down there like any other gangsters. Hi, Mike. You guys, Kim, and you, Bobby, are great together, like spaghetti and clams.
Thank you.
Want to laugh? That was on my mind today.
You wanted spaghetti and
clams? I love linguine and clam sauce. I love it. I make it a lot. I haven't made it. The other night we were eating, I told her, I said, I got to have pasta tonight. You know when you just get in that mood?
Mm-hmm.
And then we were up there in Maine. We got a shrimp scampi. I can't believe how good this place was.
All right. So since you like spaghetti, I know the answer, but I have to ask, red or white sauce?
Well, I'm going to tell you, I'll eat spaghetti with certain things. I'm not a spaghetti linguine guy, unless it's with clam sauce or like a shrimp, a lobster diavolo. I like it with that. Sunday gravy, never will there be spaghetti on my plate, you know. But I like it with a marinara, but more with an olive oil. Like, I love aioli.
Right.
You know?
Well, the clam sauce, because I know, what's the other clam when it's a red sauce?
Oh, that's still a clam sauce. Oh, all right. You could have it either way.
Okay.
That's like linguine, what do you call it? Scampi.
Yes.
That's it. That's in the butter olive oil sauce. Right. And you can make it also with a red sauce. When I do it in that, I make it diavolo.
Right.
You know? Steak pizza, aioli, all that. Right. Like, yeah. I'll have spaghetti with that. I won't have it with other things. Right. You know? Arturo, Bobby, did you like Little Richie Italian Ice? That is in Everett. I had it last weekend. Yeah, I did like Richie's. Did you like Richie's?
Yeah, they're good.
It was all right.
Yeah.
It was all right. They're right.
They're right when you come off and when you get out of the casino.
Yeah, they're over there. Yeah, they're not. What do you? I kid it. Revere Beach Parkway.
Yes. No.
Not so mine. All right. Hey, Brian.
Hi, Brian.
I didn't see what happened. You took a while, honey. We just said hi to him. We got the gun. All right. Hi, Bobby. Sorry I'm late. Looking good, pal. Hi, Kim. What's up, my brother? All right. In my opinion, who was the biggest goof in your days of the Boston mob? Be truthful. No one will get hurt feelings. I come on. Man, I think I know who this is, and I love this guy.
Yeah.
That, and he knows that, but I can't say that. I'm not going to. Out of the main guys, you know who it was. There was two of them in the North End, but I'm not going to say. All right, Mike, do you remember the hamburger place in the combat zone that had the big glass windows in the hot dog joint on Washington and LaGrange Street? I don't remember. Because we always thought, all right. Well, you know, you had the Naked Eye on Washington Street, you know. LaGrange Street. I don't remember that hot dog joint.
I don't remember the hot dog joint, but he made me think of Buzzies, and I want a nice turkey.
Oh, Buzzies roast beef?
With those potatoes.
Yeah, oh. I haven't eaten in there in 100 years over there.
Well,
yeah.
It's all gone now, but miss the Buzzies.
Yeah. What was the stature of the Buffalino family when you were in the street? Oh, status. What did I say, statue? I'm starting to get dialed out. When you were in the street. Some people don't realize that the Pennsylvania actually had three families. Philly, Pittsburgh, and Scranton. Oh, yeah, I knew there were different crews there. No, I knew that, you know. We never talked about them, though. Like I said, Unc used to talk about them all the time. Wanted to take guys up here. You remember the Jews bars in the zone? That's familiar. I do remember that.
I wasn't allowed in the zone.
Yeah, but right out of the zone was the Roxy.
I'm joking.
Yeah. Oh,
and
okay.
I wasn't allowed there.
Oh, yeah. That don't mean you didn't go. We were always up there.
Yeah.
All right. The juice bars would open at 2 a.m. when the bars closed. I don't know if I ever went to them. All right. What's this?
The truth?
Yeah, of course. Huge fan of. You miss Paul Tanzo? Well, good luck with you with that. Because I don't. Little piece of shit. All right, what else are we doing here? Bobby, I have a great question for you. IG, you could only name one thing. What would it be the only trait someone would need the most to survive on the streets? I have my own opinion, but I value yours. Cunning. Integrity. That's what I feel. All right, Mario. Bob, do you think the mob today is making money from point shaving college sports, like the Boston College scandal? Listen, I don't even know how many people are even actually making money off of that. You know what I mean? I don't even know. I got to be honest with you. I haven't paid attention to that. Bobby, did you know Jimmy Farrow? And Johnny Bartolo, legendary bookmakers from Maverick Square. I spent a lot of time down at Maverick Square. I didn't know them personally, but I think Johnny Bartolo was related to, because my mother's it was into Bartolo, and then they made a Bartolo. But my mother's maiden name was still into Bartolo. So I think we were related to them. I'm not sure. I remember my mother telling a story. I'm not sure. Yeah. Yeah.
I think that.
All right, where are we going now? Bobby, I have your back. I'll help you do it. I'm very versed in it. All right, good. Thank you. All right, Frank. Did the Philly family run any of the famous steak joint spots in the city? Not that I know of. Not that I know of. This show was top-notch, Bobby. It's always more professional than the others. Thank you. Thank you. Did you ever meet Howie Winters or Pat Nee? What did you think of them? I never met Howie or Pat. Never, because I was always a East Boston, not that guy. We never went up to Somerville. I did that in my later years. They were already gone. When I had to crop in Somerville on Ball Square, they were gone already, those guys.
Sherry was thinking like me, right away.
Yeah. Is she talking to me?
Yeah, she said, Bobby, white or red? Meaning, what type of clam sauce do you like?
Oh,
white or
red clam sauce? I was thinking about Howie Winters. I'm sorry. I like the white, honey. I like the white. If I make anything in a tomato sauce, it has to be spicy, you know, like that, something like that. The shrimp, the clams. The juice bar was an average. All right, that was across from the Roxy, right, Mark? I don't remember. Yep.
She was reading my mind.
All right. Bobby, I'm sure you remember the little place on Bennington Street that made the best lemon slush in the world. Let me tell you, that place there, right, was the best. That slush was amazing. Do you remember the place on Bennington Street?
Not really.
It was up from London Street. It was like kind of like where Anthony Champ is. It was near, I think, near the corner of Brooks, if I remember right. Okay. I'm trying to think. Because I did a building over there. When I came back, I did a few condos over there. And I remember the slush stand was there. The thing, that slush was amazing.
The years are getting in my head.
What's that?
I said the years are getting mixed up in my head.
I know. They are making it again on the corner of Bennington Street. All right, Bennington and Putman. Okay. All right, okay. Also, did you know Kevin Weiss? I knew Kevin. Yep. My answer to the last question is instinct. No matter how tough and strong a guy thinks he is, he's eventually going down if he isn't humble enough or sense danger and avoid it. That's right.
Yeah.
That's very good. Red clam sauce is just with the addition of tomatoes. Yeah, that's all it is, really. Is that Sherry crying, laughing over there?
Yes, it is.
Let me see what she's doing.
She's just like.
Look at Sheila. Yeah, cunning and instinct. Yep. I love tuna oil and garlic pasta. Well, let me tell you, Big G, what my grandmother used to make all the time. She used to make tuna gravy. You ever have that, Kim? You got the Italian tuna in the can, but I know it don't sound good.
No, I don't eat seafood.
Oh, you don't?
I'm one of those that, like, I try and I just can't do it.
My grandmother would get the Italian tuna with the olive oil.
Yep.
Dump that out, obviously, strain it a little, and she'd make a sauce for me. And she put the marinara and she put just the tuna in there. And we'd have it over spaghetti. I got to tell you, I got to make it sometime.
Oh. I had the.
No, it's amazing.
We got stuffed artichoke. We're out at a restaurant.
Yeah.
I was like, you're not eating the stuffed artichoke? The artichoke hearts. The stuffed artichoke.
That's the whole artichoke.
And I said, but there's seafood in it. He goes, no, there's not. And I'm like, you want to make a bet? I cut into it. I said, see, because I took a bite and I knew, and I was able to find just the little shred of seafood in it. They had crab meat in there.
Oh, so they had it in the stuffing.
Yep.
Oh, all right. And then it went down into it.
For me, I couldn't have it.
Yep. All right. Chevy saying hi to Sheila. Scott, hi, Chevy. All right. All right. Bobby, the teaching you posted a few days ago was great. I love the mom stuff, but it says a lot about you that you put your energy into spreading the word of God. I think that's what the Lord wants. I mean, I love doing this show. You know, we've been talking about, I really love this show, interacting with everybody and doing interviews. I just like to do that. But my passion is for the Christian show. And I'll tell you, one of the guys sent the money in to pay for the all the legal work for the nonprofit organization that we're going to have now. So we're really putting a church together.
Good.
You know, it's a YouTube ministry, and we're touching people with it. And, you know, I love the supporters that I have.
And the thing is, that's what's so wonderful, is it's not forced upon you. You have the choice to go to it.
Yes.
And
right.
This is just us saying, in between everything going on,
yeah,
you know, this is how we feel. You don't have to. That's okay.
Yeah.
You don't have to come join us on Sunday.
Yeah.
And that's the wonderful thing about it. And if you have a little bit that you're just curious, that's where you say, you know what, maybe Sunday I'll come check out this episode.
Yeah.
And that's all we hope. And that's why you know, we share it. And speaking of that, why don't we go to a commercial to show them a little bit about that?
Which commercial do we have to do that?
Oh, I thought you had one up there. No?
No, not for that.
Oh,
I'm sorry,
come
Kim.
On, that was a
I forgot
meeting.
To fix. I know. I forgot to fix that.
All right. That was a good try, though.
No, but you're right, because that's another one I forgot to put up. I've been busy. I've been trying to do all these shows.
I know.
We got a show tomorrow, 2 o'clock. We got a show Friday. Maybe two of them on the weekend. I'm trying to do all these different shows to push the book and get back out there again, you know?
People don't realize it's a lot of work.
It's just a lot of work on the computers. I didn't even do everything. Just taking down those commercials. You know how much time I had to spend on that? All right, Frank. When you were in the street, what was Cousin Oscar's opinion of the Los Angeles family? Were they active when you were around? Never even talked about them. To me, LA was an open city. Anybody could go there and do whatever they wanted. There wasn't an outfit strong enough down there. I don't care what anybody says. And LA was so big. There's so many sections there. It's like Florida. All the families are in Florida.
Yeah.
The Traficantes, the Holly, I don't even know if there's any left. I did time on one of them. You know, and he's the only one I met in the whole prison system I was in. But it's different. Different. I just made stuff artichokes. Ugh. Heaven.
I'm jealous.
Well, I'll tell you, if they're made right, you know, but I really don't even like to chew on the leaves and the stuffing. I love the hearts.
Oh.
And you know what I do now? I buy the hearts in the jar in the olive oil. I put them in the salad.
When my stomach doesn't work anymore, that broke my heart. I cried when I realized after eating how much pain I was in.
Yeah.
I can't eat them no more.
Oh.
I'm like, I won't even make them now just because I can't have it.
I love artichokes, so don't get me wrong. And I get the stuff and the leaves and everything, but I love the hearts. Love them. All right. Paranoid. I could easily see Netflix picking up your show. Oh, I didn't tell you what happened today.
No, you did not tell me. Please no. Enlighten me.
Let me enlighten you a little. I got contacted by Netflix today.
Is it a dancing woohoo contact, or is it like, oh yeah, I don't.
I think it's going to be a dancing contact. So we'll see what happens. I think they're doing a documentary.
Okay.
So I really like Netflix.
Don't get me started on that show that just ended.
Yeah. You know. Mark, you're right. He's Boston Slush with Vodka. I remember those days. And Sheila would know. He's Boston Slush. That's right, honey. You see Sheila? Absolutely.
Yeah, absolutely.
I remember those days. Wow, that was amazing, that slush. Who would win a war today between the current Patriarca family versus Joey Love and Johnny Cakes? I got to give it to Joey Love, I think. Oh, that's too funny. Big G. Oh, I love that too, Barbie. Sheila, hit me up via text. Tell Bobby I meant with the platform like Ike's. Looking good, Bobby. You are a fantastic one. Thank you, brother. Today must be a Philly day, laugh out loud. Well, I'm actually tomorrow at 2 o'clock doing a Philly show. The sit down with Jeff. So, and I've heard Jeff say a few things about me in the past, but not bad. You know,
right?
But you expect that. So, but I'm doing a show tomorrow. Bobby, you're always positive, and I enjoy your genuine personality and respect you give to others. God bless you and your family. Thank you.
All right, should we try to commentate for the beer commercial again?
No, we gotta go actually to our Estee commercial, right up. Yep, right there. Hey everybody, why don't you come up to my Bobby Luisi store on Estee? We got men's t-shirts in black and white, women's V-neck t-shirts in black and white, a shot cup, the Robert Luisi Ministry coffee mug, the Bobby Luisi Show coffee mug, and of course, God's Plans Revealed. And coming out right now, and it'll be out in August, pre-order your book right now from Capital Christian.
I'll tell you, I got to redo that thing. I did it fast, and I just, I tried it three times to end that. I couldn't do it. I'm not the guy to do that. Well, I got to get someone to do that commercial, because the commercial come out pretty good.
I could do it, I just can't read it.
Yeah, that would be a problem. That would be like take 27.
It wouldn't be that.
All right, Sean. Bobby, can you name a time in your life where your integrity saved your life or got you a pass? Well, let me tell you something. People in the life respect integrity. And because you're a man of integrity, they'll believe what you're telling them. Because that's everything that we're based on. You know, because there's a lot of people that push a lot of nonsense out there on the street to talk against people. You know, but if they know you're a man of integrity, that'll get you off of some beefs. And yes, it's helped me. You know, also, and it might sound weird, my integrity got me in a lot of beefs too. Because I questions other people's integrity.
I was going to say, how did your, that makes more sense.
Yeah. Hey, Richard. Bobby, forgot about our families. I think the Boston guys were the sharpest of all. I think so, too. Sherry, we have tuna gravy and other fish like a scangili on Christmas Eve. All right, see, other people do it because she's Italian. I mean, other people. Yeah, but other people do the tuna gravy, too. It's really phenomenal. I got to tell you. And I do put cheese on it. And I put cheese on linguine and clam sauce. And I put cheese on everything. Because I don't think white with white wine and all that nonsense. I drink what I want to drink. Although I haven't had a glass of wine, I don't know how long, you know. But I don't go by any rules. I go by my taste buds.
Since I gifted wine.
Yes. That's the last time. And how many months ago was that?
That was a few months back.
Yeah, because Sabrina sent that wine.
Yeah.
Then we got that wine up from Maine. Yeah. All right. Did you ever meet Angelo Lutz when you were in Philly? Angelo, yes, all the time. Always with Angelo. Actually, when I used to take my car down there, Angelo used to pick it up when I stood at the hotel in my town car. And then he used to come and pick me up, Angelo. I loved Angelo. And I heard he's doing good now. He's got a restaurant down there, I think. Wow. If he still has that. Nice guy. All right. Here on Staten Island, New York, we have Ralph's Italian Ice, Uncle Luigi's Italian Ice, and Rita's Homemade Italian Ice. They are all fantastic. I'm sure they are. But this recipe that we got, now in Philly, they called it water ice. Because Georgie one day says, you want a water ice? Water, what? Water and ice? No, water ice. He's looking at me like I'm supposed to know.
Yeah.
So we go to the said, no, this is slush. We call it slush in Boston. Yeah. You know, but down there, they call it water ice. If you remember that guy pushing fit you to the Netflix and Prime Video Lapa Lapa, that's great news. Yep. What is the best Italian ice in Boston, in your opinion? I haven't had it in years. I really haven't.
No.
I didn't know that they were making that ice again on Bennington Street. Gonna have to go by there.
I was just thinking that.
No,
yeah.
Bennington apartment?
Yeah.
That stuff is amazing. You know? And in the North End on Salem in, what's that, Palmetto?
Mm-hmm.
Their slush is amazing too. And I know they're still doing it. I think I had one last year. Was that last year? Was down? I don't remember. But I got to go check it out. Right in the corner store. It's amazing. Because those are all homemade.
Yeah.
They'll make the barrel and that's it. You know, when we had our ice cream store years ago when I was a kid, my mother my father Santo, we had the ice cream. We got like Richie Slush would take the slush in, and Slush King, I think it was still.
Yeah, Slush King.
Is that the one? Slush King. And then I forget where we used to get the ice cream from, but it was all brought in.
Right.
You know? We never made
that. Twist and Shake has. I think there's Slush King, right?
I'm not even sure. Bobby, we have the best ministry and the best parishioners. I can't begin to tell you how much I have learned from your teachings. Thank you for that, Sherry. Thank you so much for saying that. That makes me feel good, and that makes it all worth it.
Yeah.
And let me tell you, I'm coming strong with the demons this week, so everybody be prepared. My favorite flavors.
What would yours be?
Mine, just the love lemon.
Lemon.
Lemon
I like
slush.
Blue vanilla. I'm a blue vanilla, sometimes cherry.
That's Slush King, though. That ain't even right.
That ain't right?
The real homemade is lemon.
This is true.
All right. Michael, when did you write Cabo to Christian Bob? I wrote that in prison. I'm going to tell you a funny story. There were guys in the unit riding on me, talking to reporters and everybody. I don't know how they were getting out of the units with that stuff. So I see a newspaper article from George Anastasia, and he used to write bad about me. I think he wrote it in his book, too, The Last Gangster. He says, Bobby is writing a book of his life from Capo to Christian. I didn't call it that. Someone said that to him.
Right.
I says, you know what? That's a great name. I took the name. I'm looking through, Christian Broadcasting Network,
yep.
CBN.
Yeah.
They did an article on me on that book. They said who I was and that I was writing this book. This was years ago. I just found it a few weeks ago. I said, look at this. I'm getting publicity in a book I never wrote. Well, I wrote it, but I never published, you know? So anyway, I was in prison and I was writing because my Christian book I called The Last Generation. Then I changed it to God's Plans Revealed. Same book, though. Everything's the same. And I started writing Cabo to Christian. And I said, I got to put this down on paper. This is my testimony. So it started in prison. When I got out, I published The Last Generation. And I was sitting on that because I wanted a writer to give it a better twist. And I had Ralph Azzullo, who's a great author out of New York and California. And, a few people took a shot at it. They wanted to see Cabo to Christian isn't a Christian book, really. It talks about my part. It's really, if you want to look at it, it's more like a horror story. What happened to me that night, what it leads into, you know. But I wrote it. Everybody that read it liked it. You know, I was waiting to get a real good author to help me do it. And I decided to self-publish. Because the book that Emily's writing is, I think, is Four to the Floor, the Bobby Luisi story.
Right.
But she's going to write an in-depth gangster book about me and the mob wars and all that. So I felt I had to publish this one because a lot of people want to know what happened to me that night and how did I get to that point. And I think this book explains that. I really think it does. But yes, I started writing that 20 years ago.
And for more information, you'll have to order the book.
Yeah. Oh, so they're doing it already. All right, Frank. When you're a main guy, do you get the best of wines and best of foods? Absolutely. If you go to the best of restaurants. But, you know, I had my favorite restaurants that I went to. Okay, Sheila. I know you didn't mean to do it.
Yeah, no, but that was more, she was talking to somebody
else. I know, but still, I want to put up, I feel sane, Sherry, love our ministry. And you know what the main thing is? It is our ministry. It's not like it's my church, it's my thing, it's my thing. No, it's not.
Right.
Because God doesn't work like that. We're a community. We're all together, you know, and everybody is equal. I just happen to be the teacher.
That's right.
But everybody in there is equal in the eyes of God. You know what it says in the book? Jesus said about John the Baptist being one of the greatest of all the prophets, but the least in heaven. Because God doesn't look at that. He looks at the heart. So whatever you do on this earth, no matter how great it is, not that I'm doing great, because I don't mean that, but it's about the heart. And it's about everybody's heart that watches this show. That's what it's about. It's like here, we have a community. You know, sometimes we got 150 people watching at once. We got 63 people, it's 90 degrees out. The whole country is beautiful. Overseas though, I mean, who wants to sit in the house right now?
Right.
But we still have people that love the show and that want to be involved in it.
And God bless it.
It's the same thing with the church. You know, I've been doing it the past weekends, 20, 25 people at a time.
Yeah.
You know, over 100 watch or whatever. And it's just a great community. You know, it really is. I just love to do it.
And when's that on?
Sundays at 6:30.
And that's when they can see it live?
Well, what I do is I pre-tape the show. I show that first, like I did with these shows tonight with the commercials and everything. And then I'm on live. So I do a true stream, And I just sit here and read the questions. It's nice, you know.
Now, can they subscribe to that, or is that on?
No, there's only 200 and something members right now. We got to get over 1,000 to start subscribing and everything.
So they should just at least start liking the show. Just click the thumbs up button on that.
Yeah, they could do that, but also, you know, there's a donation button, all that. You know, it's like a regular church thing. So
okay.
I would never want anybody to send a super chat to that show because, you know, they get a third of it, YouTube. And that's God's money. They shouldn't do that.
Right.
Hi, Steve. Bobby, excellent show. I own Royal Roast Beef. Saratoga Meridian. Imagine that. All right. Stefano. All right. Look at that.
Now you're bringing up stuff. Now you're going to make me hungry.
Listen, Royal's Roast Beef, I love. Let me tell you. You know, I opened Robbie's Roast Beef on Salem Street in Medford, which was crazy because Alamo Roast Beef was down the other end of Salem Street. But I still always love roast beef sandwiches, fried clams, and all that. So I always copy Royals, Riley's Roast Beef. Whatever they did, I try to do in the store. You know? But it's just I didn't have the right people working it. They worked hard in there. My sister-in-law, everybody, Richie. But it just didn't really work out. You know?
Well, he's going to have to make us up.
Yeah. Congrats. Hope the Netflix documentary works out. There's only a couple of you guys out there to speak on Liquors and Hospital. Yeah, well, they contacted me today, so we'll see what happens, you know. Okay. Jared Hotz, shame. Bobby, you have to work for that delicious hot leaf by leaf. Oh, till you get to the peace of heaven. Yeah, you do. No, I know I do. God forbid. Sherry, that I peeled them off and they need to stuff them. My mother would kill me, you know? And I do love that, but again, I love the hot.
I get that.
And it's great. It's really great in a salad. You know, the baby springs and all. Oh, yeah. All right. John Panisi told a story about a May guy getting an oiled back massage from another guy in prison. Shouldn't that guy be shelved? Yeah, he should. You shouldn't have a guy touching you. You're the cheese man, Bobby. I'm not the cheese man, brother. No way. Hi, Sheila. I love integrity. You're a man of integrity, Bobby. Thank you. And you're a woman of beauty. Big G. Hi, Bobby. Do you like the squid salad a mother makes on Christmas? Stuffed squid too. I love stuffed squid. My mother makes it with either breadcrumb or she does it with the ricotta cheese too. It's amazing either way. I love that in the gravy. Forgot about it. And yeah, I like squid salad. And I'm big on calamari. I love squid itself. I love octopus. I could have octopus on my salad. It's high in protein and really good for you, you know?
Thank you, Chewy.
I like that.
Though. I don't like that texture.
What was Joey Bellino's opinion on Angelo Lutz? Did he look out for him? You know, I really don't know. Angelo was around us all the time, so he never, Joey never said nothing about Angelo. Douche Marouche, I don't know if anyone ever asked this question before, but did Joey Merlino dislike the nickname Skinny Joey? I don't know. I got to be honest with you. I don't know. Bella Notley back here. Where have you been? Was there an exorcism ceremony on Gaia Street in Method? They would have been better off if they did have an exorcism there. That's too funny. I like the watermelon and lemon flavors. Yeah. Yeah, me too. But I'm more partial to the lemon. What is your favorite Italian restaurant and best Italian sub in Boston? You want to know something? I haven't had a sub in Boston for a long time.
Yeah, I know. Not in Boston.
I haven't had one. And I haven't been to my favorite restaurant in the North End since I've been home. I've been going to all these other joints. So, all right. Bobby Slush King bought the recipe. Okay. They bought the recipe from Bennington Street? Is that what he's saying?
I don't know if it was Bennington or whose recipe they bought.
They had to buy the Bennington Street recipe. Because that was... It was in a little, remember the door, the small, and it just had the round. You remember that?
Yeah, it's more familiar, like now, like I'm picturing it, but.
The one in the North End, it would actually be sometimes lemon seeds in there. That's how, no, that's how fresh it was.
I remember that though.
Yeah. Did I ever hear Joey talk about his father? Not much. You know, not much. Crystal Watt, I love your ministry too. Bobby and Sherry are the best. Thank you. Sherry's doing great with those prayers every day. God bless you, Sherry, for that. Ramson is my man. You should get George Anastasia back on the show. You guys had a good show together. I love George. I've got to tell you. He's really a good guy. You know, I was going to reach out because I want to hear more on Stephen Mazzone and the guys and see how they're making out, to be honest. I'm kind of worried about them. I hate to hear guys are going back to prison, you know. That was lemon ice, Italian ice. I like that. But to me, Italian ice is hard.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know if they're calling slush Italian ice.
See, that to me would be that water ice is Italian ice to me more than a slush. You know what I mean? Because yeah. The Italian ice is harder like an ice.
I get a scraper with a spoon.
Yeah.
Yeah. All right. Is your Bobby available on Amazon? I would have bought it yesterday. No, Sean, go down. There's links down there for eBay or Etsy. You click on them, and then you go up. You'll see the book. And you can pre-order the book on either one. Philly Water Ice. Bellinopoly Batcave. Where is this joint? Oh. What was the hottest thing about being jailed for 14 years, Bobby? That's really a tough one. Well, you know, when you start getting used to the time, you know, it passes better. You got to get through all those heartaches, the people you miss, and settle in. It took me a while to do that. But once I did, I was happier. You know, from maybe 2004 on, my bit started getting easy. Even though I was going back and forth to court at 20 years, waiting for appeals, that was the roughest part. But, you know, I think God helped me get through it all. A lot of guys do tough bits. I did not do a tough bit like that. I didn't enjoy it, but I settled in. Big G, again, my brother. Oh, Bobby, I love your roast beef joint. Method back in the day. Yeah, remember that, G? I called it Robbie's Roast Beef. I named that after my son, obviously. You know, some people didn't like the name, but the roast beef joint was good. It was good. Actually, when I first opened, Richie Gillis was helping me with it. He was working in there with Lena. They were doing a great job with it. Then it slowed down, and then my sister-in-law went in there with my brother-in-law, and they were running it for a while. You know, but it was just, I opened all these places because I thought it was going to funnel all this drug money through there. And I just end up keep putting them on the street, you know? Yeah. Okay. All right. Bobby, great show tonight. I'll see you Sunday. I love you, buddy. Thank you, Richard. Make sure, Richard, you're there, boy. All right. Hello, Springfield here. All right, brother. Love Springfield. All right. What is this? What was that?
You already answered it, that it was the book. He was saying.
Yeah, no, it's not on Amazon yet. I'm not pulling From Capital Christian on Amazon. You could get God's Plan Revealed on Amazon, but not Capital Christian. All right, Sean. I used to get the steak, Bellino sub on Prince Street. It's good. Where on Prince Street did you get the sub? Oh, Porchetta. Oh, from Artus. Let me tell you, I was in Artus twice a week. They have a Porchetta. You know how they make it? Did you eat it in there?
I can't recall.
They got the rotisserie oven, right? Then they make an eggplant like spread in the middle. Oh my God. You know, now I'm craving it. He just said that. I got to go in there and eat an Artus. Frank, not to bother you about it, but do you ever foresee welcoming Paulie back into your life and forgiving him? Or do you think you're better off just keeping your distance and wishing him well? I'm going to tell you this, and I'll tell you this straight out. I still love Paulie. You don't stop loving people. But what Paulie did and the shit that he tried to do, I'm never going to have him around me again. He can never be a friend to me again because I seen his true heart. So, not going to happen.
All right.
Is that a good answer, Kim?
That's a very good answer. Yeah.
All right. Bobby, Richie, and I are recruiting our pals. We go to Bible study with during the week at the Inner Circle. We have two newcomers for this Sunday. Oh, that's going to be great. Thank you. Thank you, Richie. Thank you so much.
All right. I'm going to, since there's a few minutes left, I think this would be a good time to show the Etsy commercial one more time so they could see, again, where to look for the book on Etsy.
Yes, and the links are down below. So let's do that. That's a good idea.
That's a good idea. That one right there, right?
Yeah, the books are on that one, yeah.
All right.
Oh, you could go to the 2-minute one. Go to the 2-minute one. That's probably better.
This one?
No. Go down. Do you like that one? I like
that
one.
That one.
Oh, hello, everybody. Thank you for joining me right now. I just want to talk about my new book coming out, From Capital Christian. You know, it's been years I've been wanting to put this book out. I wrote most of it in prison. And I'm proud of the book. And, you know, the content of the book, it just shows you it goes from my childhood right through the war in the 90s. And, you know, what happened to me that night that everybody wants to know about, that demonic encounter that I had that lasted over 8 hours. That's all in that book. I don't get deep into the war. I don't get descriptive with anything. Emily is going to be doing a book of my life story. That's really going to be detailed. But this book here is, I wrote it as a testimony. So, I really believe that, you know, you'll enjoy the read. What I'm going to do is I'm selling it on Etsy and eBay right now on pre-sale. People already started to come up and pre-order the book. It's amazing. I had a feeling this was going to happen. What I want to do for the first several months or more is actually handle every book, personally sign them, and mail them out to the people. So, I don't know. I mean, I think by the time the book comes out, I don't know how many are going to be there, how many I'm going to need, how many I'm mailing out. But I'll tell you what I'm going to do. As the orders come in, that's the order that the book's going to go out. If you're second, third, fourth, fifth, 10th, 20th, that's how they're going to go. So if you like, go up to Etsy now, go up to eBay, pre-order your book. And as soon as they come rolling off the press, they're going to be mailed to you. All right. Thank you. And I hope you enjoy the read. Well, you know, Capo to Christian in the United States, I paid for the delivery. I can't do that with this book. You know, it's a little different. It's costing me a lot of money to.
Well, prices on everything.
No, no. When you self-publish, you have to get the cover made.
Yeah.
Someone to restructure the book. They put it in paper form. What do you call that? Kindle.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's costing me a lot of money. But I think it's worth it just, you know, just to give the story out to people understand a little better about my life and what happened to me.
And you're signing these ones.
Yeah, every one of them is going to be signed.
So that's an added thing that not every book gets.
No, I'm going to do that for a few months, see how it works, and then we'll put it up on Amazon with the Kindle. But right now, it's just going to be me signing them and mailing them personally myself. That's how I'm going to do it.
So everybody should get their pre-orders in.
Yep. So what do we got here? All right, Sean. I believe it's Domino's Calf Bobby. When I'm in the North End, maybe I'll go try that. But now I'm on this R2 kick. I got to go eat there now and get a pork sandwich. Thank you, Michael, for watching. Listen, I love all you guys. Come on, join us on Sunday. Come and check this out. We're going to be talking about demonic activity, the fall of Lucifer. We're going to be getting into some deep stuff. This teaching here might take 3 or 4 weeks. I don't know. But I'm going to go over it slow, and I want everybody to understand it. So I want to thank you all for tonight. Big G, I'll be in touch with you by Friday. Hopefully I'll have all that paperwork together and send it over to you. And God bless you all. And thank you, Zal. And Sherry, again, thank you for the daily prayers, because that's amazing. They're loving it. It's very important. So God bless everybody. Richie, Ollie's, all my friends. And come on. I'll see you on Sunday. God bless everybody.